builds my faith. I have little iPods throughout my house, and I play scriptures and play those scriptures just to be reading through the house, because when I'm getting dressed, I want something to enter me, because what enters me determines what exits me. I never study my doubts. I begin to listen to the Word of God, and it's called the law of displacement. How did we get the darkness to leave this room? We turned on the light, and the entry of the light forces the exit of the darkness. So when His Word enters me, doubt leaves me. You don't study something you want to leave. You become bonded with what you focus on. So you focus on His Word. You bring His Word into you. And His Word is a cleansing agent. It purifies and it drives out the darkness and the unbelief. This is why I teach people, don't study your weakness, study your difference. You must make a decision. I will build my faith. I will work with my faith. Now, God uses pictures to build our faith. Abraham, see the stars? That's what your children are going to be like. Jeremiah, you're a mighty man of God. He said, I'm a child. God slapped his mouth and said, shut up, don't say that. Say what I'm saying. Say what I'm seeing. And when he began to talk and say the words of God, faith began to build in his life. Faith can be built every hour of your life, every day of your life, by what you speak, what you listen to others to speak into your life. Remember that faith is the only way to generate favor with God. God does not react to your pain. He sees it. He does not respond to pain. He does not respond to tears. He responds to faith. Remember, God's only need is to be trusted. I consider Numbers 23:19 to be the most important scripture in the Bible. God is not a man. God is not a man. God is not a man that he should lie, nor the son of man that he should repent. He has spoken it, he's spoken it, he will perform it. God wants to be trusted. God wants to be trusted. God wants to be trusted. Ever since Lucifer rebelled against God and tried to displace God, God's been working with people who will trust him. God will put his investment in people who trust him. God will give his secrets to people who trust him. Everything that you do in your life shows that you trust God or you don't trust God. Work with your faith. The second decision is your decision to excel in your present assignment. Let's say that together. Your decision to excel in your present assignment. We have a leader here, of course, who has the spirit of excellence, which is different than just excellence. There's a spirit of excellence similar to Daniel. The spirit of excellence means you want things in order, things in place. Remember that the obsession of God is order. Every instruction is to create order, the accurate arrangement of things. That's what excellence is. Excellence is the highest level of order. Excel in your present assignment. Today is the seed for tomorrow. Today is the seed for tomorrow. The excellence of today will not be rewarded today. It'll be rewarded tomorrow. How do you excel in your present assignment? How do you excel? Let's talk about your assignment. My glasses solve a problem. My microphone solves a problem. My watch solves a problem. Everything created solves a problem. My eyes see, my ears hear, my mouth speaks, my mind thinks. Everything on the earth is a solution to a problem. The problem God sculptured you, designed you to solve, is your assignment. If your name is Moses, your assignment's to the Israelites. But if your name is Aaron, your assignment's to Moses. Your assignment is always to a person or a group of people. How do you know to whom you are assigned? Whose pain do you feel? Whose tears affect you? Whose success creates joy in you? Whose enemies do you want to confront? Your assignment must become your obsession. You build your appointments around your assignment. You build your day around your assignment. Your assignment is always geographical. Where you are matters as much as what you are. Where you are determines the gifts that flourish in you, where you're rewarded. Your assignment must become your total life. Now, how do you excel in your present assignment? Who's authorized? Who is authorized to give you instruction? What is your job description? What is expected of you? I got very upset over all the joblessness because I have a real strong opinion about unemployment. I think everywhere there's a problem, there's a job. And everywhere there's a job, there's a future. So everybody was telling me, I'm out of a job, I'm out of a job. I said, that is your new job, to find a job. That is your new job. I went on the internet, I said, there's four things I want you to do. And I guarantee you'll have a job in 7 days. I said, number one, wherever you believe you're supposed to be working, yes, thanks. Somebody thinks of everything, right? Thank you. Good. Wherever you plan to work, obviously you want to know the company, so you study its website, you study its product, so when you go in for a job, you know exactly what that company does. You know what it's about. But I said, whoever you're interviewing for a job, I want you to make four statements, and I guarantee you'll have a job in 7 days. Number one, tell the man that's interviewing you, you will never have to repeat an instruction to me. You will never have to repeat an instruction to me. Number two, I complete everything I begin. You will never have to ask me for a status report. I complete every instruction you give me. Three, I am agreeable with anybody that I work with. Put me in any department, I am agreeable to work around. Four, I am easy to correct. Make me your protege. Become my mentor. I am very easy to correct. I taught this on the internet because I actually believe that if you are a reliable employee, if you can be trusted with an instruction, you can be trusted. If you cannot be trusted with an instruction, you cannot be trusted. Remember that. I begin to get phone calls and emails all over the world from people who had gotten jobs. One young lady in India, who's probably watching now, she made the statement to me in an email. She said she sat down, the man had all of her paperwork in front of him, and he said, before I go through this paperwork, talk to me. So she said those four things to him. When she finished the four statements, he looked at her and stamped, approved, you got a job. Didn't even look at her papers. Excel. Excellence makes you unforgettable. Excellence has a fragrance. Just like dishonor has an odor, Excellence has a fragrance. I told Pastor, I said, I am learning from you. I won't go into the detail, but he did something specifically for me. Something broke that I had, and when he got it fixed, he went way beyond the extra mile, and I was talking about it today. I said, I'm learning from you. I can't be as good as him, but I will. I'll get there. But he has this obsession. Now, that may be hard to live with sometimes, somebody that's obsessed with excellence. But he excels. Do you excel? Joseph excelled in the prison, and it made him needed in the palace. The problem you solve qualifies you for your salary. You're never paid for your gift. You're paid for the problem you solve with your gift. Remember that when you change the problem you solve, you change your salary. That's all your assignment is to solve the problem you see. Solve the problem closest to you, and it becomes your exit from the prison. All of your life there will be problems, because if there weren't problems, there'd be no marriages nor friendships. Problems make you necessary. Problems are the seeds for rewards. Problems are invitations to relationship. Problems birth the reward system on the earth. I want to stress again, until somebody has a problem, you're unnecessary. Notice the problem. I'll give you a little part of it. When I came through the security, one of my lens of my glasses was out. I didn't even notice it. I think Pastor has eagle eyes. I think he could see what I'm doing in the United States. He looked over there and says, you got a missing lens in your glass. And I did. He said, I'll take that and we'll have it fixed. But it was more than fixed. It came back in a beautiful gift box that I want to keep the rest of my life. And I had two extra pairs, a silver and a gold pair that he had for me. I sat there, I got to learn how to do this. I took pictures, Pastor. I took pictures of the three glasses of what you sent on my iPhone. And it's the first picture when you turn on my iPhone to remind me excellence. Look at somebody next to you and say, you need this. You need this. Excellence. Excel in your present assignment. Excellence is a magnet for right people. Excellence is a silent conversation about your expectations. One area of excellence that's very needed, I've never met a poor man who valued his time, never have. Never met a rich man who didn't. If you were to ask me, Mike, you've been around the poor. Not only have I been around the poor, I've been poor. I came from a very poor family. But I began to watch the wealthy, and I read every book. I read every billionaire's book, every statement, the five investment laws of Warren Buffett, etc. I read everything because I know there's a difference. The number one difference I have found between poverty, people who are poor, and the prosperity to come to your life. Remember, the first thing God gave you was time as currency. You are a walking currency system. Remember that every God quality has value. Your time has value. Your words have value. Your energy has value. Your presence is an investment. If you spend time with someone, your presence is an investment in them. And we'll talk about that tomorrow night, about the investor. Because God has invested in you.